Welcome to our classroom. We are on our week 7 of quarter 3. Claire, first let us start with a prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. Lord Jesus, I pray today that you multiply your grace on me, subtract and take away all of my sins by your mercy you have shed on me. Add to my awareness a better understanding of your will for me in my life. I will divide my blessings and grace with those that are not as fortunate as I am. In your perfect and most holy name, I come to you, Jesus, and ask these things. Amen. So once again, I'm your grade 7 mathematics teacher, Maria Eliza Nunez. Our objective for this week is to illustrate a circle and the terms related to it, like radius, diameter, chord, center, arc, central angle, and inscribe angle. First, let us start with the definition of circle. Circle is the set of all points on a plane having a fixed distance from a fixed point called center. Below are some of the words related to it. Look for the words related to circle, either horizontal, vertical, diagonal, and even upside down. So here is your find the words related to our circle. We have 5 words there. Good luck if you find it all. So here are the terms related to circle. Let us start with center, then the definition of it, and you will find out the illustration on the very right corner of this table. So, center is a fixed point in the circle. So, here is our center, the point A. And your circle is usually named by our center. So, that circle will be named now as circle A. Next term is radius. The plural of radius is radii. It is a line segment from the center to any point on the circle. So here's the illustration. Line segment from the center to any point on the circle. So this time you have radius AB or line segment AB. Next term is the diameter. Diameter is a line segment that passes through the center and whose endpoints lie on the circle. Take note of the next definition that I'm going to say. Diameter is also a chord that passes through the center of the circle. Another concept, it is twice the radius. And here is the diameter on our illustration. Again, it should passes through the center and the endpoint should lie on the circle. Therefore, your line segment or diameter is diameter CD or line segment CD. It is twice the radius because I can have radius AC and radius AD. Next, chord. Chord is a line segment joining 2 points on the circle. Take note, on the circle. So, our chord is this. We can have the EF, chord EF or line segment EF. We can also have our diameter as a chord, the line segment CD. Remember, your diameter is the longest chord that you can have in a circle. Next, we have the concept of arc. Okay, arc is a portion of a circle. We have 3 kinds of an arc. We have the semicircle, the minor arc, and the major arc. Let us start with semicircle. Semicircle, it is an arc that is half a circle. So if it is half a circle on our illustration here, we have the circle A, again, because that is your center. So circle A can have the semicircle GH, semicircle GH, or you can use the three letters because it have it there, the semicircle GBH. How about the minor arc? Minor arc is an arc shorter than a semicircle. Shorter than a semicircle. So let us look again in our figure. We have minor arc BG, which is shorter to our semicircle, and minor arc BH. Again, that is shorter to our semicircle. And as you can see, there's a symbol in writing your arc. So when you're being asked for the arc, you should also name it with that symbol. Next is major arc. Major arc is an arc longer than a semicircle. Take note that it's longer than a semicircle. Let us go back with our figure. Major arc, you can have BHG, which is now longer. Or you can counterclockwise, GHB. So we have major arc BHG or major arc GHB. It will be the same. Next, we have also the central angle. Central angle is an angle whose sides are two radii of the circle and whose vertex is the center of the circle. Take note, the vertex should be the center of the circle. And the angles or the side should be a radii of our circle. So we have now angle BAG. Again, your central angle should have an vertex in the center and radii of our circle. Then we also have the inscribe. Inscribe angle is an angle whose vertex is on the circle and whose sides contain chords of the circle. This time it should contain chords, not radii. And the vertex should be on the circle. So this time our vertex is this J. So I can name the angle as angle HJI. Or you can also name it as angle IJH. It will be the same. As long as the vertex is on the circle and it contains the chord of your circle. Okay, let us have some examples, more examples. Using the figure, identify the parts of the circle. We have here this figure. Our center now is P. So a circle is named, again, just to remind you, a circle is named by its center. Thus, we call the circle on the left, circle P. And when you are asked what is the center, just answer P. What are the radii? Because as you can see in the figure, we're not looking for just radius. We're looking for radii because there are too many radius here. So I can have radii PA, PC, and PB. And on the diameter, take note, we just have one diameter. So this is diameter BC or diameter CB. How about the chords? I can have chord DE and chord BC. Your diameter is a chord, so it still should be written as a chord when it is being asked. Arcs So for arcs, we just combine all, starting from the semicircle, minor arc, major arc. So we have, for the minor arc, arc CA, arc AB, arc ED. For the semicircle, we can have, no, rather, for the major arc, we have arc ABC. This is the major arc, arc ABC, arc AEC, arc CEB is the semicircle. But there's still many more if you want to take a look on those arcs. So for central angles, we can have angle CPA and angle APB. We have two central angles this time. Angle CPA for this part and angle APB for the other part. Okay, next, illustrate circle B. Illustrate, it means we're going to draw what is being asked. So illustrate circle B having radius BC. So if I draw, this should be my circle B. I will point the point B. Then I ask radius BC, so I should put the C there on the circle. So I now have the radius BC. For the next one, I was being asked for the diameter AD. I already have the B on the center, so I just put the A and the D, whatever place. Just make sure that you pass through to your center B to make that diameter. For the chords, since we already have the chord AD, the other chord will be ED. So I just place a point E that is connected to my point D to make it as a chord. And for the arcs, since you already built this, you can take a look if you gave the arcs that is being asked. So we are being asked to construct the arcs DC. It's already there. Arc CA, I already have it. Arc AE, I already have it. Arc DCA, I already have it. And arc DEA. So we're done with that. For the central angles, am I able to make angle ABC? Angle ABC, of course, I have. I'm able. Angle CBD, yeah, I also have. And for the inscribed angle, I have angle A. DE, do I have? Yeah, I have an angle ADE. So that's how I construct this. So take note, you just need to construct, as you can see, radius, diameter, and chord. And for the arcs, central angles, and inscribed angle, if it is being asked, you just need to take a look if you're able to give what is being asked to be constructed. Next. So we're done with the examples. So learning tasks, this is the things that you're going to do now on a piece of paper. For the first task, you need to look around inside your house. Illustrate five things that represent a circle. Take note, if I say illustrate, it means you need to draw. Draw five things that represent a circle. For the learning task two, using compass, a ruler, and a protractor, because it has an exact measurement here that it says, draw a circle having number one, M as the center. So you will have a circle M. And then you should draw for number two, a radius naming MO of 3 centimeter. Should be just 3 centimeter. For number three, diameter OP of 6 centimeter. It should be just 6 centimeter. For the chord, QR of 4 centimeter. It should be just 4 centimeter. For the central angle, you should have angle OMS of 60 degree. Take note of the measurement, because when I check your work, it should be the exact measurement that being asked. Trivia. This is another thing for you to do on a piece of paper. On what body part of the cricket do its ears located? So just a trivia related to your science. So direction to answer the trivia, name the parts of the circle given to the left and choose the corresponding of the parts at the right. Write the letter of the answer box below, but I wasn't able to make a box there. So you can just write your answer at the top of the number that is being asked. So here is the figure you're going to take a look for you to answer the five items. And here is the five items. And line segment NO, you need to choose there. We have radius, chord, diameter, center. Then for number two, line segment PN. For number three, line segment QP. For number four, line segment QM. And for number five, point Q. Take note, there are answers that could be repeated. As you can see, we just have four choices. So there should be an answer that must be repeated. Okay, so that's it. The learning task one, learning task two, and the trivia are the things that you need to answer for you to finish this module. And then finally, you can make your reflection through video blog, narrative post, photo journal, or to your preferred reflective mode of documentation. Just don't forget to state the three statements: I learned that, I realized that, I will do. Then you can finally say, madaling madali ang math, as simple as that. Once again, I'm your grade 7 mathematics teacher, Maria Eliza Nunez, now signing off.